Since the invention of the first computers, the very same people who helped to develop them realized that the memory devices were developing far slower than the processors. So, on the one hand, the processor's performance increased rapidly, as also the resources, but the memory devices were developing far slower, so they couldn't match the processor's performance.
This figure shows a motherboard where there is a processor on the left and a memory device on the right that represents the main memory or primary memory. Yet another memory device is a hard drive that acts as a secondary memory. The processor itself has several cache levels inside that are smaller memories that allow it to transfer data much faster than the other memory devices. When the processor requires some data to be transferred, it will be, in the worst case, retrieved from the secondary memory. If that happens, the required data has to cross all the memory levels before it reaches the core. After being processed, the results of the operations are stored back in the memory subsystem. First, they are stored in the upper levels, but ultimately they will be transferred to the last levels of the memory hierarchy. These transferences are limited by the number of elements that the processor can transfer at once, and also by the time they take to complete. When the data is stored in the hard drive, the latency will be the highest. When large datasets are too required for some applications, the processor is limited by the rate at which data can be delivered from and to the memory hierarchy, and therefore it cannot fully use its resources. The processing architecture devised by these theses operates at cache level and eliminates the necessity of transferring the data to the processor. Instead, the processing core informs the compute cache system of the operations that are to be performed on the data. Afterwards, the required datasets are retrieved from one of the cache levels, processed and stored back. This architecture does not only eliminate the need of transferring data all the way to the processor, but also has access to more elements at a time. Thus, it also computes the results quicker.
The architecture was tested using reconfigurable devices, and it was shown that even for rather simple problems, it can easily perform 100 times faster using about 60 times less energy than a regular system. Now, the processor that was used for comparison was a rather simple one. Our goal now is to integrate this architecture with a processor that could ship with a laptop, with a smartphone, or even with a server, and hopefully to get our devices, like these ones, to work faster using less energy.